Hello and welcome to The Diary. This program is aimed at creating awareness on issues related to children. Last week we discussed about budgeting for children and how important it is to create awareness to parents, children and the general public on budgeting. And this week we are looking at the same topic but on a different angle. We look at how government plans, budgets, implements programs and provides services and monitoring and evaluation on budget to children needs. My name is Colin Sorono and joining me today is our usual guest, Mr. Elijah Don Bonyo from the Joining Forces Alliance. Karibu sana.
Thank you.
One thing that I thought after last week's conversation was that there is a lot of need, there is need for us to create more awareness on children budgeting because of the need that is out there. Mm-hmm. There seems to be barely no information when it comes to budgeting on children, and people look for information, and you know, information is power. So today we are talking about budgeting on children, but we are looking at the figures that the government has been putting into place, or the departments that are mandated to deal with children, and we're looking at two main departments, and probably you'll just give us a brief on what are these departments that deal with the services of children in this country.
Thank you very much, Collins. Well, like we said last week, when you're talking about budgeting for children, we start with what are the rights for children. In our constitution, all these rights are well provided for in Article 53. Now, we have the National Council for Children Services that has a mandate to provide policy direction on children matters. They have a mandate to coordinate planning and budgeting for children. In Kenya, right now, we have a National Plan of Action for Children, 2015 to 2022, that provides a broader framework on priority areas for children. The challenge we have is that that plan of action was not costed, and therefore many other departments that are supposed to be guided by that plan have to cost by themselves. Now, apart from the National Council for Children Services, I'm sure many of us, most of the time, make reference to Department for Children Services. The mandate for Department for Children Services is largely to lead and coordinate child protection. So it's important that we separate those two entities. A National Council for Children Services has an overall mandate for policy guidance, planning, and coordinating, and of course, oversight on children matters, while Department of Children Services is largely on child protection. Remember the other ministries that have mandates on other aspects on children rights, like Minister of Health will be driving the right to health, and Minister of Education, the right to education and other ministries. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Bonyo. And before we continue, I want to tell you guys that we have several documents here that are going to act as our reference points. So all these documents are going to guide this conversation so that we don't just talk from maybe from no reference point. Yeah. Mr. Elijah, I know you're familiar with these documents. So for you, when you see these documents, what comes in your mind in relation to children?
Thanks. Thank you very much, Collins.
Yes.
Now these documents are just part of the documents we need to look at anytime we're discussing budgeting for children.
Yes.
Ideally, every department has a longer-term plan, like we said last week, and an annual plan. And then they're also supposed to have an annual report, right? Now, for today, we are going to be informed by what is known as the sector working group report. And for these budget proposals that are in parliament, the sector working group reports were made available by end of last year. So we, that's one document. The second document that is important for us is the budget policy statement. The budget policy statement was presented to Parliament in February and approved. And then the last document is the budget before Parliament. But the last bit has three parts. This one, you see this one. This is program-based budget. It's almost 1,000 pages. Now, when you talk about children matters, you are literally supposed to go through this document page by page. So our members of parliament are having these copies and they're going through them page by page, right? So the program-based budget is one document. Now, the others one we're showing, then we have the recurrent estimates, which is into two volumes. We have volume one and volume two. And then we have development estimates, which in three volumes, volume one, two, and three. So for you to understand what government has prioritized for children, you literally must go through all these documents. Like I said, the Department for Children Services is just one unit whose plans and budgets are largely on child protection. The National Council for Children Services has an overall mandate that enables them to look at how is government planning generally for children, how is government financing children matters. So what comes to mind is a child who is not able to access these documents. And if me and you are confronted with these huge documents, how about the child whom you are talking about? Now we need to move away from huge documents to simplified documents that will enable children to read and understand and engage. So our recommendation at the onset is that government and partners needs to consider investing in synthesizing budget documents in formats and content that children can understand. Thank you.
All right, thank you very much. And you mentioned something to do with a unit. I just heard somewhere you saying a unit. And I want to ask you, do we have a Department of Children Services in the first place, or is just a unit under another department?
Okay, an interesting question. Now, I want to be very specific to what the documentation.
Yeah, that is in relation to the documents that you already have.
So, the most recent guidelines from National Treasury, those guidelines that are guiding the current budget process, there's a section where sectors have been outlined. Now, in each of those sectors, we have state departments. Now, for Department of Children Services as we know it, there's a sector for social protection, right?
Yes.
Now, under that sector, we have state departments. Now, the Department of Children Services is under a state department for social protection. Now, this is the thing. If you go to Ministry of Education, you will find a state department for early learning and basic education.
Yes.
Specifically for basic education matters.
Yes.
If you come to this other sector, you will not see Department of Children Services as a state department. That's important to know. And even the National Council for Children Services, you will not see it as a state department. So meaning that, in my view, the placing of the Department of Children Services at that level is not where it should be. It would make more sense for me if we go to a day in this country when we'll have a state department responsible purely for children matters. Remember, most of the state departments, the leadership of the state departments, most of them are principal secretaries. So we have a principal secretary responsible for basic education, for example.
Yes.
But we don't have a principal secretary specific to children matters. We have a principal secretary responsible for social protection. And under that, there are other units. So we would be happy as children actors the day we'll have children matters substantively being placed under state department. It gives it more weight, it gives it more visibility. Thank you.
So in short, what you're saying is children services are not under a ministry, they're not under a state department, but they are under a unit under social protection.
Okay, let's understand first, what are children services? Now, look at it from children services as several. We have education as a service.
Yes.
We have health as a service, right? We have water as a service. So what we are saying here is not children services. We are simply saying the department that has the responsibility to lead the planning and coordination of child protection.
Yes.
Called Department of Children Services should be elevated.
Okay.
To a state department level. Now, there's a benefit to that.
Yes.
And we'll come back to later before the show ends.
Yes, probably. I think we need to clarify that before maybe we get there. How important is it to have our children, like children as a department, probably, instead of just...
Okay.
Yes.
Why this is important, remember, we have child protection starting at the household level, the unit level, because that's where children live. So when you are designing programs for child protection, you are supposed to take in consideration the total number of households in the country. Take in consideration the population of children. Now, the population of children that we are talking about, that this department should be designing programs for, so to guarantee their safety and protection, is huge. Now, that responsibility for child protection is a huge responsibility. And that only way we are going to end violence against children if we strengthen child protection. And strengthening child protection requires strengthening mechanisms at the local level, moving upwards. So for me, the responsibility that the Department of Children Services has is a huge responsibility. It requires a lot of investments. It requires a lot of visibility. Thank you.
All right. It requires a lot of investment and visibility so that to make children more visible as we are Mtoto News. So let me because we want to talk more about the previous budgets and how effective they have been from the documents that we have. Maybe just to understand you, maybe to give you a chance to explain this from your work, what you've been working on. Do you think that the budgets that have been allocated previously to children has been sufficient enough? Let me say the Department of Children Services.
Okay.
Has it been sufficient enough to cater for children needs?
I would say not sufficient, not adequate. This is the thing. Every year, we normally look at the sector report. Most recently, sometime in November, we looked at the sector reports and narrowed down to the priorities under the State Department for Social Protection, where Department of Children Services is. And you begin to see that the department has priorities, and these priorities, there's a program, and then after a program, there's sub-programs and delivery units. Now, these priorities is what informs what resources will be allocated for.
Okay.
Now, and remember, we are not talking about priorities for 1 year. We're talking about a 5-year priority starting from 2018 as aligned to the medium-term plan. So if you look at those priorities, they're not as explicit to the level that it will inform prioritization of resource allocation. So in November, we analyzed those documents. We developed a memorandum. This was a collaboration between Joining Forces and Children Agenda Forum. So we analyzed those documents. We submitted a memorandum because Treasury had provided an opportunity for interested actors to provide memoranda or proposal to the sector. So we pointed out what some of these issues are. And one of the issues that we pointed out was that for child protection sector, right now, we have a national prevention and response plan on violence against children. Now, this plan shows us what we must do as a country to end violence against children. So largely it's child protection. But if you look at the sector report, where their priorities were outlined, then we couldn't find the priorities in the National Prevention and Response Plan in this other document that was treasury. So we raised that and we gave recommendations. Fast forward, after the treasury completed this process, so the treasury was preparing the national budget policy statement. So we quickly took the draft national budget policy statement again and analyzed it and made recommendations to remind treasury that we are still concerned that the priorities for child protection are not in the budget policy statement. And even made a recommendation that can the budget policy statement provide a substantive paragraph that the government of Kenya will prioritize children matters, specifically child protection. Where we are now, the proposed budget estimates in parliament, again, this is missing. So perhaps why it's missing is a history of not being prioritized early enough on a long-term period, and also lack of alignment of this other national prevention response plan to the plan that is driving the department. And if this time, we'd be able to show you exactly what these plans are. And unless that is addressed, we are still not going to achieve investment for child protection. Now, look at a sub-county children officer who is based somewhere very far away from Nairobi, for example. This sub-county children officer has a responsibility to ensure that children are protected from all forms of violence. Mm. Apart from protection or prevention, they have a responsibility to respond, but they have no money. They have no money, that's the reality. Make any phone call to any sub-county children officer and ask them, in your office today, what resources do you have for doing the work you're supposed to do? So I think that we need to come together as civil society actors to advocate on behalf of the Department of Children's Services. Because I'm sure they are doing their part. But unless many voices speak to Treasury, unless many voices speak to Parliament, we are not going to get resources adequate enough for child protection. Thank you.
So let me understand this. So we have an office and there's no financing of the office.
Yes, let me bring the other bit of the National Council for Children's Services so that you see this. National Council for Children's Services, that has a responsibility on planning and coordination. They published revised guidelines on area advisory councils. Now, those guidelines remind us that you're supposed to have an area advisory council from the local level, location level, for example, to the ward level, to the sub-county level and county level. Now, what should be happening at that level is planning for children's services at that level. But they have no resources even to convene planning meetings. Now, if the area advisory council do not have resources to collect data on children issues, they don't have resources to convene meetings to analyze the data, they don't have resources to utilize that data to plan, such that they're able to inform other sectors on what children matters are, then already even those other sectors will not prioritize children matters. So the answer is yes, I can tell you for sure. The area advisory councils are not resourced. The sub-county children officers have very minimal resources. And like I say again, today it's about evidence. Given a chance, we'll be able to show what we have established page by page And if there's any contrary information that we don't have, we'll be happy to receive it. Thank you.
Now, so whose responsibility is it to budget for these offices that you've mentioned? And who is failing in their mandate?
Okay. All of us, we elected leaders. These leaders, at national level, then parliament. And parliament has two houses, the National Assembly and the Senate. So the National Assembly, the leaders we elected, have a huge responsibility of answering to the electorate why child protection is not prioritized, because they approve the budget. And therefore, if you are approving the budget and you are not concerned about child protection, and you approve the budget every year. So for me, I wouldn't want to, this blame squarely lies with the National Assembly. Unless National Assembly prioritizes child protection as a problem. I will tell you why. This document that I have, the one I'm showing you. Now, this is the budget summary. In this budget summary, National Treasury is providing responses to the concerns from Parliament. So when Parliament was discussing the National Budget Policy Statement, they raised some concerns. National Treasury is giving responses to all those concerns. Those concerns, none of them is on child protection. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much. You've mentioned about the National Assembly, but also I think budget, before it gets to the National Assembly, it's being proposed by certain offices. And here we mentioned about the Department of Children's Services. So do we say even the Department of Children's Services is failing in terms of proposing the budget for the like offices for maybe child protection in sub-county and all those other offices?
Okay, this is a good one. It would have been good to have the Department of Children's Services here with us so that they tell their part of the story.
Yes.
But there's something I don't want us to forget. You know, when we are into an election year, like in 2017, there were political party promises. These political party promises translated into government plan. So we must ask ourselves, did the political party promises include child protection? If yes, were they translated in the plan? You know, if yes, have they been translated into the budget? So the Department of Children Services, I can tell you for sure, they have done a good job in terms of prioritization and planning as a department level. But there's a missing link between, I don't know what happens, between what the department has planned to Treasury, I don't know what happens. Because you look at what the Department of Children Services have planned,
yes,
based on their own documentation, you see priority properly. Now you look at what Treasury has captured as a priority, there's a problem. But between the department and Treasury, there's a social sector working group. And in the social sector working group, this is where discussions happen. And this is where people are prioritizing. And I will tell you again, the Treasury guidelines indicates that prioritization is done at the sector working group level. Now, in my view, if the Department of Children Services would be raised to a level of a state department, then they're likely to advocate properly at the sector prioritization level.
All so right.
Because they're not there, I think because they're not at that level,
okay,
maybe they're giving their proposals, but these proposals are disappearing somewhere. I don't know where.
So you're saying maybe. We don't have evidence whether the department gives these proposals to the Treasury, right?
Okay. The evidence we have before us is the sector working group report,
yes,
that has priorities. But I'm telling you, the priorities, the sector working group report, are not aligned to what we know are the priorities for the Department for Children Services.
All right, thank you very much, Mr. Bonyo, for that explanation. We are ending our first round of the discussion. When we come back, we are going, of course, to continue with the rest of the discussion that we have lined up for you, including issues such as the budgets that have been allocated and what the Department of Children Services has been able to achieve in relation to the documents that we have. That is after the break.